What is up? So my name is Vanessa Rowe. For those of you that don't know me, I actually very much enjoy Canva and I enjoy making graphics. So I figured I'd come here after lots and lots of messages of people coming to me saying, oh my God, I can't figure out Canva. Can you help me? And I'm one of those people that just kind of figure things out on their own. So it can be hard for me to explain how to do things without physically showing you. So I'm here today to help you guys with a few Canva pointers. I'll walk you through creating graphics, editing graphics, just kind of briefly so that hopefully this is something that can help you. Let me first start off by saying though that creating graphics is not income producing. Listen, real life pictures is going to do more for your business. You showing people how you use your products in your life will do more than any graphic ever will. So do not rely on graphics for marketing, okay? There are a right place and a right time for graphics, but first and foremost, this is something that you need to do after you take care of the income producing activities. So those are things like follow-up, parties, booking parties, prepping for parties, asking people to reorder, posting on your VIP group consistently. After you do the important stuff, the meat and potatoes of your business, then you can spend time on the graphics. But I do not want you to start your work in your day with just graphics, okay? Even if it brings you joy, because it brings me joy and I love doing it, you just trust me on that one, okay? Because you're going to get caught up in the graphic world and then it's going to be 3 hours later and then you'll be like, look at all these pretty graphics, but I have no PRV this month. So make sure you take care of what's important first, then work on graphics. So let me go ahead and screen share with you guys so you can see what we're working on. Perfect. So here is Canva. I do pay for Canva. So I really can't tell you what it's like for the free version, because as soon as I got it, like as soon as I found out what it was, I paid for it. I was not worried. So there may be a few things on here that I do that are with the paid version only. I don't really know what to tell you about that one. So let me first say Canva is best on a desktop. It is not good on a phone unless you are already very savvy with it on a computer. But first and foremost, always use it on a computer if you can. So desktop, this is what your home screen is going to look like. We have templates here. So this is how you're going to determine what size graphic you're going to create. So Facebook posts are usually what I'm going for because I'm usually posting straight to Facebook. We also have things like Facebook cover photos. These are great for if you're creating a cover photo for your team, your group on Facebook, that's for your team, the groups on Facebook for your VIPs, the groups on Facebook for parties. All right. So that's what I use most often. You can create things like logos on here. You could do posters, but basically what the difference is between all of these things is the size and quality of the graphics. So Facebook posts is, again, almost what I do every time. If you're looking to create a flyer, so like a newsletter to send out to your team or to send out to your customers, I use the flyer, okay? All right, so what we're going to do first is let me show you how to edit a graphic. So this is my catalog cover that I'm using for the spring, summer 2022 catalog. This is very specific to my branding. So when you do branding, it's an assortment of different colors, different images, different styles. So for me, I love everything watercolor. My colors are greens, like different shades of green, yellow, and kind of like a blush pink or like a mauve. I use plants a ton in my branding. So that is why this looks the way that it does. The other part of your branding is different fonts that you stick with. All right, so here we are in Canva. This is, so you could see, here's your file. This is where you could name things. You could change all sorts of stuff, make a copy, download it. So what we're going to do first is make a copy because I don't want to edit the original graphic that I had. So this is my copy. It's going to say so right here in the title, which is again, where you can change that. But here, let me just show you how to go through a few things. So if I wanted to change what this said, I click on this and you're going to notice up here, that's all of the different fonts. So you can pick one, you can click here and it's going to give you a few different options. Or so like if I'm looking for a display, here's their suggested options on different display fonts. So I could click this one. And if I really like that, I'd say, okay, cool. Go back. If I don't like those, you can go through their popular list. The ones with the crown are, you do have to have a paid subscription for. So keep that in mind. It is going to track your recently used. The ones up top here are the ones that are included in your graphic that you're already making. So let's go say, let's use sunflowers. Now you can increase the size of this by moving those little circles and making it bigger, or you can head over to this number and change it based off of that. Obviously that's way too small. It only goes up to 144. So if I wanted it bigger, I can either extend it this way or I could click on this and change the number manually with my keyboard. Obviously I don't need it that big. Let's go back to 144. I'm going to drag it to the center. And you're going to see a solid magenta line that is the center of the graphic. Okay, so that's how you change fonts. Now, this is a frame with an image inside of it. So if you head over to the Elements tab, scroll down to where it says Frames, you can pick a frame. So this is basically, I'll click this. Let's see, let's add a frame here. And then I could grab a picture, so I can go to Uploads. You click on upload media, and that is where you would take pictures from your computer or from your phone. Let's say I want to use this one. I'll grab it, drag it here, and you'll notice it goes straight into that frame. So if you don't like the way this fits, you can click on it and press crop. Now you can zoom in, however, you cannot zoom out. You can move it up and down, but you cannot make it smaller. So if you don't like how that looks, you're just gonna have to delete it, delete the frame, and try a different frame. So if I wanted that to be more rectangular so it fit everything, I could look through my different frame options and grab something like this. You could change the colors of that if you look right here, if I wanted it dark green. Anytime you see this cute little sky, that means you can put a picture in it. So let's grab my picture and boom. There we go. Fits right in the frame. It all moves together and is super cute. So I'll go ahead and delete that, show you guys. You can also grab images and just upload them. So for example, you could save these from the workstation or from your PWS and put those in there. Again, you're going to click upload media and then just drag it over. So you'll see that this is trying to cling to my other frames. If you want it to just be out, I would do this. Shrink it down and move it wherever you need it to go. Just like that. Okay. So these images, the plants and the chair, those actually come from Canva. So if you head over to their elements section, not only are you going to find those frames, but if I go back, you're also going to find lots of other stuff. So they have plenty of lines and shapes for you to customize and use. So if I wanted this heart, I can grab it, I can change the colors in it, I can change the size of it like that. You can grab ones like this, the square, you can make it taller, you can make it wider, you can make the whole dang thing bigger. Again, change the colors, super easy. Your graphics, so it's going to, graphics are just images that they make. Again, they have it subcategorized. Recently used, it is going to track what images you used recently, which does come in handy a ton. So that is there, but let's say we're looking for something specific. So let's go ahead and get rid of these. And the more, you kind of want to be specific when you ask for this. So I can type in plant and it's going to give me a whole bunch of stuff, right? You're going to see ones that move. You're going to see ones that are outlines. You're going to see ones that are whole pictures versus just the cutouts. And that's not what I'm looking for specifically. So they'll give you options like paper, leaves, houseplant. So if I were to click on paper, that is going to change it completely. But it gives you things that are similar. So other things that people might search. So let's go back to plants. So let's say I want plants and I want them to be watercolor style. So you can type in watercolor plants and you're going to find an assortment of different really pretty options. So let's say that I really, really, really like this one. So we'll make this smaller, make that a touch smaller and pop it in the corner. Super cute, loving that. Okay, now this is my favorite part about Canva. If you see magic recommendations, see all, this is going to show you all other graphics or images that they have that are similar to the one you just selected. So that way you can find things that might work really well aesthetically with the graphic that you've already chosen. So for example, let's say that I really liked this big Monstera and I wanted to kind of use it on the side here like this. Then I could do that and you'll see that they have very similar styles. Now you can edit these graphics, certain ones. If you click on it and it says edit image, you can do a ton with this. So you can adjust the brightness, you can adjust the contrast, which either makes it more definition or less definition. Saturation is going to give it more vibrancy, more yellow tones. If you go less on the saturation, it's going to turn more gray and more blue. Now here we have different filters, so you can again play with those, get them to be the color that you want. You can add in frames. They have all sorts of different ways that you can edit these images. So you could also click on adjust here. This is going to give you even more ways that you can edit this besides just brightness, contrast, and saturation. So I want this to be a little closer in color to that green. So what I'm going to do is give it more saturation. I'm going to have it go a little bit more towards the green tint. I need it to be less saturated. Maybe decrease the contrast, give it a touch more brightness, give it a little more warmth, and less on highlights. And there you go. So you could see how that graphic just changed. Here we are. You want your images when you create them to be very balanced. So notice how I have this in the upper right corner. If I got rid of this altogether, it's no longer balanced. But to balance it out, I put this in the bottom left corner. So I kind of like to go opposites when it comes to corners. I like to stick to similar shapes. So you'll notice that all of these are circles. When you round your text, that also helps it just kind of add more aesthetics to it. And again, this might be some advanced editing for you guys, depending on where you're at. So let me show you really quick how I rounded these. So you would take any verbiage you have. So let's go back to that catalog highlights. And if you click on effects, you're going to see right here, it has the option to curve. Now, if you have it to the right, it's going to curve this way. If you move it to the left, it's going to curve the other way. So if I wanted it to curve like this, I could totally do that. So there we go. Catalog highlights, curved. You can make it more curved, less curved, just like those, and place them. You'll see how it has a circle, so you can make sure it's centered with that little bullseye kind of right in the middle. That'll show you. All right, cool. So let's see, what else can I show you guys? You can change up the background. So for me, what I did is I went to elements and I was looking for yellow background and I wanted it to be watercolor because that's my style. Everything's kind of watercolored. So what I typed in, yellow, because that's part of my branding, and watercolor. So I did yellow, watercolor, and it's going to show you an assortment of images. You can take this and drag it over, and you'll see that it replaces the background. Now, I have a white piece over top here because, oh, it's locked. So I locked this image. So all you would do is press the lock or unlock. When it's locked, you cannot delete it. You cannot move it. You would have to unlock it first. So let's go ahead and delete that and see how different this graphic looks. So when I get rid of the white, it is not as crisp and clear, but when I have the white in there, it's a little easier to read and it makes the graphic just, I think it blends a little better. So let's go ahead and get rid of that and replace the background with this. So this is another route you can go. So it has the yellow, it has the white, but to me, this yellow is just a little too bright. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click on this background graphic. I'm gonna head over to this transparency button. And when you lower the transparency, it actually makes it a little more opaque or see-through. So I like how that looks a little better. You could also move your graphic. So click on it again, press crop. And again, you can make this bigger. You could move it around. Let's do that and see how different it looks. There we go. All right. So that's just some examples on how you would do that. So I hope that helps you guys. Now let's go back to this homepage. Let me show you a few other things. So let's go ahead and create a newsletter together. So the February newsletter is going to be the warmer of the month. So I'm going to log. We're not going to worry about that actually. So what I would do is I add in things like specials that are going on. So like bring back my bar, talk about that. My little graphic, my girl at the bottom, I paid to have her done. So I did not create her. I just use her in all my stuff. But this is just basically what I would do. So you could take a real life picture, pop it in here. You can go to your workstation, or not your workstation, your website. So let's go to my website really quick. Go to Scent and Warmer of the Month. Better Together. So look at all of these image options. So I'm going to click this one, copy image, bring it back over, control paste. Now I have a picture of the warmer off. And I'm going to take another picture of the warmer turned on because it does look so different. Shrink that down in size. Now you notice it was kind of hard for me to grab this because these other images are in front of it. So just try and get to, you only have that highlighted. That needs to be a little bit smaller. Line them up. See if they look okay. I think it still needs to be a touch smaller. And there we go. So what I would do, it's called Better Together Warmer. So highlight that, Better Together. I'm going to get rid of that rainbow, but instead I can replace it with a heart. So go to elements, type in red heart. You'll find all of these super cute little images, which you can use. I like this one. So let's go ahead and grab that, make it smaller, pop it back here. And it's too dark for me. It doesn't contrast enough with the black. So what I'm going to do is change the opacity, the transparency of it, to make it a little lighter. So check that price, which is $45. So we'll say 45 in January only. All right, so let's change this to say January, since that's the information we already have. And okay, so now we have these warmers. I'm going to copy this text so that way it keeps the same size and font, and it's just easier that way. So I'm going to say turned on. And I want that to be all capital letters. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to keep this highlighted, highlight those words. I'm going to click on this icon, which is uppercase, and it turns all of it into uppercase letters. I want another one the exact same size so that I can line it up. You're going to see how these lines are hitting in the center. So they're aligned with that bring back my bar and how it's aligned with the turned on. Change that to off. Line it up nice. So you'll notice that I can't move the turned on. That's because this one is wider. So let's make it smaller so it doesn't overlap as much, and bring it over. All right, perfect. So that means it's lined up perfectly. So we have turned off, move that over just a touch, move this one over just a touch, and it's not center. Okay, there we go. So turned off and turned on. I think it should be a little smaller. So let's move it to 14. Change this one to also be 14 so that they match up. Line it up, make sure it is centered. And there we go. All right. So we have our Better Together Warmer. I'm going to replace this image with a real life picture of that warmer. So if you are ever looking for real life pictures, what I would do is go to Pinterest, type in the name of your warmer that you're looking for. So thank you. Better Together Scentsy. And you're going to see tons of pictures pop up, specifically ones that are created by customers, which is super convenient because real life pictures always, always, always sell a warmer way more than a picture from the workstation. So we're going to take that one. I want to make it a little shorter so it's a little more cropped. And it's really hard for me to highlight. So what I'm going to do is right click, bring to the front. So that way you can change. So sending backwards brings it behind all the graphics, bringing it to the back brings it behind everything. If you bring it to the front or bring forward, that means it puts it in front of everything else. So let's grab this, make it a little smaller. We can put that up here. Okay, and now we need to change up the scent. So let's go to back to the scent and warmer of the month. We're gonna pull up Sun Ripened Berries. I'm gonna copy this image. Delete this one, paste this one here. So obviously it's way too big. Now it's behind everything. So I'm gonna try and get it so I don't have any other boxes interfering. And just like that, boom, boom, boom. All right, let's change the top name of that to Sun Ripened Berries. Perfect. Okay, now what you're gonna notice is that this just changed all of the font. So I'm gonna get rid of this because this is the previous description. I'm gonna go make that smaller. It's like 16, perfect. Now I go back here, copy, paste. Now I want this to be I want this top one to be a different font. So if you highlight just this, you are only editing those words. So you could change the color. I want it to be maybe a little more of a pinky red rather than a super bright red. So change there. You could change the fonts to match the others. Now it's too small. So I'm going to highlight it again. Bring that specifically up in size, but that doesn't change the font here. Now, I don't like how wide this is. So you can drag from the side to make it a little thinner. Now we'll slide this here. We're gonna line up my wax bar so it's centered with my verbiage. And I wanna move this down a little bit so it's out of the way of the Y, which means I'm gonna have to move this down and line it up again. All right, so that's some more changing. Okay, QR codes. I think this is just something with a paid version, but I might be wrong. So you're gonna click on this little QR code. If it's not right here, then it's under the more section. But QR codes, all you need to do is copy the website. So scent and warmer of the month. Let's see, what did I have that pointing to? So right here, it says scan this code to join our group and play bingo. So this is the link to my VIP group, which I'm not going to show you guys because that's a customer only zone. But this is where I would copy the link and pop it in here. This is to place an order. So this is just to my website. So let's grab this here, go back to the homepage of my website. We're going to press copy, come back over, QR code, paste. It's going to generate a code. So now I have a new QR code. I'll delete that one, make this one a bit smaller, and pop it on over. So that's how you make a QR code. They can scan it with their phone. It's super, super easy. All right, now let's bring back my bar section. It was just the words, but I added in that fun little swipe of color because without that, it's just kind of boring to look at. So I like to add in color. I usually like to do, you could type in, so this is pretty red themed. So what I'm gonna do, and if you're not good at this, you can again, just Google it. So colors that pair well with red, because you don't want the whole document to be red. But if you look here, red, navy, and white looks good, red and turquoise, red and green, red and orange. So let's go ahead and do red and turquoise. So turquoise is another word for teal. So let's go ahead and type in teal paint And you're going to get all these fun little like paint swatches and watercolor marks. And they're just super fun. So you can take this, put it behind your word, and you'll see it's too dark. So I can try to change the transparency of it, but then it doesn't really look great. So I got rid of it all together and click on it again. Hold on. So if you're struggling to grab your image, just move the other stuff backwards and then you'll be able to grab it. No problem. All right. So I didn't like that one. It didn't work for us. So let's try something lighter like this. Now I can't really grab it because this is in the way. So I'm going to move this to the back, grab this here, and make it a little longer. And we're going to send it back. So you could see there, now we have kind of like a highlight. It's still too dark for me. So I'm going to make it a little more opaque. And there we go. So it kind of looks like a highlighter, but with some shape to it, which is a little more fun. So you could do stuff like that. Again, these are all just copy and pasted from the workstation. This is something you could change up the wording. So like add it to this party. This is one that I've used before where I've mailed it out to party guests or emailed it to party guests and just stuff like that. So you're going to keep fonts similar between each of the different graphics here. You're going to add in your QR codes. Arrows are really great. But yeah, so that's pretty much just how I create graphics. If you were creating something from scratch, I just go to templates, Facebook posts, create a blank one. And then here you can search for templates. So if I use plants and everything. So I type in plants, see what some of my options are here. Let's see. So you can grab literally any of these. This is cute. I like this plant, but I don't like that it's black. It's too much, too dark. So let's change up some colors. I don't like that font. Let's move it to something that I use very normally. And let's change up the rich. So let's pretend that I'm creating a graphic to advertise my open house. All right. Call it a VIP. Exclusive event. Make that smaller. You can do this. Here we go. And okay. So if I want to keep this same font style, same color, same size, just copy and paste it. Come over to my house on, let's say, Saturday, January 29th from 12 o'clock until 5 o'clock p.m. Now, if again, I wanted to make it taller, you just move it that way. If I want to make it wider, we'll do one of these. So we'll pop this here. Let's see, you could add in your address. So you can go to text. You could do it this way, or you could copy and paste. Address 1234 Best Avenue. It's not my actual address because you guys don't all need to know where I live. I do live in Cleveland though. So you'll see that this doesn't match. Now, I could change up the fonts, I could change up the colors, I could change up the sizes, all sorts of fun stuff. Again, like I said, you can make things all capital, all not capital. And yeah, so there we go. Address, colors, change things up. You could add in a little blurb about what you're gonna have. So we could say cash and carry items, snacks and drinks, smell the new scents, pick up a new catalog. Sweet. Now I want this to be smaller. So again, I can either shrink it this way or I could shrink it at the numbers. I want this one to be wider so that everything's on the same line. Bada bing, bada boom. I like to add in my little girl so people know it's me, or you could again add in a picture of you. So I could go to elements, frames. I like the circle frame, just kind of matches. People associate circles with my branding. So we'll pop this here, add in my picture under uploads, pop it there. Sometimes you just have to move it a little bit so you get it where you want. There it is. Boom. Now I need to move it. So I'm going to go to crop, slide it down. There we go. So now people know about my open house, and there's a little bit of information about that. This looks like it's missing a pot. So let's go ahead and go over to elements and type in pot. And let's see if we can find something. We can do this. Pop it here. Oh, look, it just needs a little, okay. Mm-mm. Oh, that's why, okay, hold on. So what I could do here is if I didn't like that pot, you can edit your image and usually there's a background remover option, but there's not. Instead though, it will allow me to change that color. So I'm gonna make it more of like a terracotta color. And then I'll get rid of this little pot here and see how I did that. So put him back here, keep that there, make it a little bigger, why not? Move my photo over and there we go. You just created a graphic with me. Congratulations. So if you have any questions, please try to Google them, because I am not going to be available to answer everyone's questions, considering how many people follow this page. But yeah, Google is your best friend. YouTube is your best friend. I'm sure there are tutorials all over the place, but I just wanted to show you guys how I use some of that. So I hope this helps. Let me know. Give me some feedback in the comments. Always happy to hear it. And I hope you guys have a wonderful day. Thank you so much for hopping on.